Good morning. This video is for all of my people who love any type of interval training. I specifically go to Orangetheory. I'm a big fan of Orangetheory and its workouts and what it has done in my body and my yoga practice. But I notice a big problem. Every time I go to Orangetheory, especially I go early so I can get my tread card, I notice a lot of people sitting about chatting. And that's not the best use of your time. Orangetheory and any interval training, HIIT training, CrossFit, you will benefit greatly from doing a warm-up, a dynamic warm-up, before you even do your exercises. Now, only you know your body, so if you're in charge of your own dynamic warm-up, you can spend more time focusing on what you need on that specific day. So, I'm going to give you what I do before Orangetheory every time I go to work out. So whenever I get to Orangetheory, there's usually a wall outside or inside I can use. If you don't have a wall, you can do all of these exercises freestanding. And yes, I will actually go outside of Orangetheory and do my dynamic warm-up. It has made a huge difference in how I feel during the workout and then after the workout. So bring your hands to your hips, separate your feet, hip-width distance apart. Bend your knees, keep your chest lifted, and just start with squats. I know you'll probably do a lot of squats in your workout, but these are warm-up squats. Straighten your legs, bend your knees, sink your weight into your hips, keep your heels, keep your chest lifted. Straighten your legs, bend your knees, straighten. Two more, and one more. Now add the arms and lift the heels. Up, lift your heels. Two more. One more. This next exercise helps you greatly with calf strain. They're eccentric calf raises. So lift up, really focus on the descent on 3, 2, 1. Lift up, focus on the descent, 3, 2, 1. Lift up, 3, 2, 1, heels lower, lift up, 3, 2, 1, heels lower, one more, 3, 2, 1. One heels lower. Now start it all over again. Sink down, straighten, 5 reps. 2 squat, 3 squat, 4, and 5. Add the arms with the heels. Up 1, up 2, up 3, up 4, up 5. Focusing on the calf raises now. Heels lower. 3, 2, 1. Lift up, lower. 3, 2, 1. Lift up, lower. 3, 2, 1. I think that's 4. Lift up, lower. 3, 2, 1. Bring your arms up overhead. Hook your thumbs. Lean over toward the left or whichever direction. Lean over toward the right. Shake it out. Bend your knees. Right leg goes straight back. We'll lunge. So pause here for a moment and just notice how your hip flexor is feeling in this front leg. And then lower the back knee down. And lift, lower, lift, lower, and lift. Now this is where the wall can come in handy if your hamstrings are very tight. And if they're not, you can keep your hands on the ground. But since we have a wall, I'll use it. So pushing against the wall, push back, straighten your front leg. If it's difficult to straighten your front leg, bend this back knee for slack. Rebend your front knee, straighten. Now notice I peel my toes back toward my face. This gives me extra stretch in the hamstrings and the calves. Bend, straighten, two more, straighten, two, last one, straighten. Rebend, hands down, switch legs. Other leg forward, lower the back knee down. Lift, lower, lift, lower, and lift. Now 5 reps of the straightening. So again, take your hands to the wall or to the ground. Straighten this front leg. Now this back knee can bend so you can get more extension in this front leg. So it's important this front leg runs straight in. Peel the toes back toward your face. We bend, straighten, we bend, straighten. Two more. Straighten, last one, straighten. Bend this front knee, stand up, turn sideways. Now, sometimes if I have a wall, step, cross, go out, lunge. So left leg goes behind right, left arm forward, right arm back. Step out, lunge, straighten this leg. Left behind right, step out, lunge. And go to the other side. This time, right behind left, or just cross the other leg behind you. Step out, lunge. Cross, step out, lunge. Cross, step out, lunge. Now you're starting to feel a little warmed up. And what I'll start to do is to get light on my feet and just bounce around a little bit, sending signals to my brain. I'm about to start that treadmill workout or that rower workout. Maybe some high knees, butt kicks. And then I go into my side-to-side lunges. So hands can come to the ground. If your knees are sensitive, it will help support some of your body weight. So bending one knee, straighten the other leg, other side. Yeah, that was my knee that just popped. Other side. As I get older, lots of things creak and pop. Other side. And going back to the other side. Now to level this up, I can bring my hands to my legs, my hands to prayer, whatever you feel comfortable with. Straighten, lean, straighten, lean, straighten, lean, straighten, lean. And come back to center. Rock back and forth. And step up. Again, light on your feet. And go out, in. Some of these patterns are mimicked from jump rope. Forward, back, side to side. And then I work on my upper body because this gets work too, a lot in Orangetheory. Three arm circles forward, one, two, three. Three arm circles back, one, two, three. Left arm forward, one, two, three. Left arm back, one, two, three. Fingertips to your shoulders, elbows touch in the middle, down and around, one, two, three. Reverse direction, one, two, and three. Shake it out. Work your hands and your wrists by opening and closing the fists. You can keep your hands here, or you can play with the levels. Bringing your arms up overhead and lowering the arms down. This will help warm up your fingertips, your wrists, your forearms, everything that's about to work really hard for you in these fitness classes. You want to make this a compound exercise. Simply begin to open and close the hands and do your eccentric calf raises. Really focusing on the slow and low down. And shake it out. Wrist circles. Circles in the other direction. Bonus round. If you're feeling pretty warm, and you should be feeling pretty warm at this point, enjoy your workout. You want to get a little bit more into your hip flexors. Go back into your lunge position, face forward, right leg goes back, back knee goes down. Slide the left foot over toward the left. Sink your hips, lift your chest, and then straighten your front leg. Feel your toes back. Sink your hips, lift your chest, straighten your front leg. Maybe you're on a hard surface, you don't want to put your back knee down. Keep your back knee lifted. Straighten your front leg, feel your toes back. Bend, straighten your front leg. Feel your toes back. One more, going to five total, and straight. Re-bend that front knee, and then switch directions. Other foot forward. So this is my right foot. I step to the outside of my right hand, and lower the back knee down, but keep it lifted. If you're lowering it down, just set yourself up, sink your hips with your chest, maybe pause for a moment here. Straighten your front leg, go back. Re-bend, straighten. Five reps total, straighten, re-bend, straighten, this is five, and straighten. Re-bend, and come up to stand. Again, light on your toes, get that blood circulating, get the heart rate going, feeling warmth in your body and in your joints. Some of us work out at 5 a.m., 6 a.m., your body has not been doing anything, so this is vital for your health and maintenance. Last. left knee in, three circles left, one, two, three, three circles right, one, two, and three. That's it, nice and simple, dynamic, do part, do all of it. Don't worry about what other people are thinking, worry about how you are going to be feeling. This is your body, this is your workout, this is your health. Take charge of it. I'll see you next time.